forcing long threes, it could lead to a successful second half for the Colonials.
VMI with the basketball. Colonials up 35-29. We're underway second half. Nick Gore has the ball, trying for the back door to Brown. Kicks it inside for Covington. A nice move off the glass and in. 35-31. Good passing from the Keydets. Full court press. Faces GW. Joe McDonald gets it up the left side to LaSan Chroma. Chroma will drive down the left wing off the glass. Rolls it home and the foul. And one for LaSan Chroma. 37-31. Only had two in the first half. What a great start for one of the leading scorers for GW.
Well, that's a tough bucket. Takes some strength to get it up to the rim there, and a nice friendly roll from the rim as well.
Nick Gore will pick up the personal foul for the Keydets. Number three on the game for Gore, and Chroma to the stripe for GW. 76% on the season. Nails it easily. 38-31, Colonials.
And he's made a major improvement in that part of his game. Free throw shooting used to be around about 58-60%.
Rodney Glasgow on the right side. Goes inside for Covington, and Chroma tried for the steal, called for the foul on the collision. First one on Chroma, first team. Right baseline, the inbound for Nick Gore. Looking to go inside, looking for Glasgow. Got it to Covington. Deep in the corner on the right baseline, comes out to the wing with the left hand. Bounce pass to Glasgow against McDonald through a screen. On the switch, Garino takes over. Up top, it's Brian Brown driving against Chroma. Nick Gore right down the lane, fires it up there. Back rim no good, tap no good, and Armwood gets the board. Joe McDonald, middle of the floor. 2-1-2 zone facing GW. Patricio Garino will drive, cross-court for Chroma. Goes inside for Larson. Over to Garino on the wing. McDonald at the top of the key. Back over to Garino. Garino will fire from the right side, short. And the rebound, Gore. Glasgow up the right side for Okoye. Brian Brown will fire the long jumper side rim. Gore, the rebound. Against Armwood, the reverse lay-in good. 38-33, George Washington.
And that was a beautiful job by Gore to use the rim as protection on the reverse layup. Isaiah Armwood, one of the best shot blockers in the country, couldn't get there.
McDonald has it over to Garino. Back to McDonald. Middle of the floor, Larson. Down the left side, Chroma, the lay-in blocked. Got his own rebound, though, on the right baseline. Garino back outside to Joe McDonald. Sets it back up. 18:04 left in the game. The lead is 5 for the Colonials. Facing that zone. You know, VMI looked at the stats. It's all 0-for-6 three-pointers for GW, so setting up that zone against the bigs. Larson, 16-footer side rim, no good, and it's working right now for VMI. They get the rebound again. Glasgow will bring up the middle of the floor. Left side is Gore, thinking about firing. Now hands off to Covington. Covington in the corner now drives into the paint. The floater, fadeaway, side rim, no good. But there's Okoye to get the rebound. Can't get it to go on the lay-in, but draws the foul. Colonials have got to get a better job of boxing out down low. The foul against McDonald.
Well, VMI looks like the team that's come out with a little bit more energy here in the second half and has made the adjustment, going to the zone, forcing GW to become jump shooters. Good strategy when GW's been getting it all done in the paint.
Okoye free throw is good, 38-34. GW Bynes is in for Chroma. One more for Okoye. And he hits them both. The leading scorer averages 19 points a game. His first 2 points of the contest. Larson up the right side for Armwood. Settles it back out for Larson and McDonald. On the wing, it is Garino. Back to McDonald. Bynes gets it to McDonald, top of the key. Larson at the free throw line. Back to Bynes. A long three-pointer, no good. And the rebound to Covington. Glasgow, no-look pass. Okoye drives and draws another foul. Armwood. Nope, it's McDonald again. Number three on McDonald.
And the defensive adjustment from VMI, getting it back into the game.
38-35, George Washington. Okoye free throw good. 38-36, 5 straight for the Keydets. They could cut it to 1. With this free throw. They were 2 for 2 from the line the whole first half. They're 3 for 3 to start the second half from the line. And the lead is down to 1. Colonials led by 9 late in the first half. It's an 11-3 run for the Keydets, and they get a steal on the full court. Okoye is fouled by Brian Bynes. First on Bynes, and now Okoye can go back to the line and get two more to give the Keydets the lead.
Well, we talked about Brian Bynes in the first half, how he got confidence from going to the free throw line. Okoye, the leading scorer for VMI, 0 points in the first half, now making a living at the free throw line. That's going to give him some confidence.
Free throws good by Okoye. 59% free throw shooter on the season. It doesn't look like it right now. 5 for 5 at the line. VMI 7 of 7 as a team from the stripe.
It's a lot easier to raise that percentage when you shoot them in a row, and it allows you to get into a rhythm from the line.
Second one no good. Off the side rim, Armwood the rebound. We're tied at 38, 7 straight from VMI. Guarino has the ball to Bynes. Up the right side at Savage. Back to Bynes across the timeline. 16:44 left, facing that zone.
Got away with the 10 seconds there.
Savage to Smith. Smith all the way down the lane. Left-handed layup is good. 40-38. Colonials getting a break on the 10-second call, and then Smith takes advantage. The lead is 2. Dwayne Smith has 6. Glasgow against Bynes. Down the lane. The floater in the paint. Good. Game tied at 40. Glasgow continues where he left off. He's got 12.
Glasgow being given some leeway there in terms of the extension of his off arm, trying to keep Bynes off him.
Guarino has it to Bynes. Middle of the floor and gets it across again, but right at 9.9 seconds. Savage has it outside to Bynes. Over to Savage. Colonial's got to gain some confidence from the outside. Smith down the lane off the glass, doesn't matter. Goes past Covington again and puts it home. 42-40, GW. Nick Gore weaving his way through. Outside, Stan Okoye. Okoye will drive against Guarino, forces the shot, no good. Rebound, Armwood. Armwood, middle of the floor to Bynes. Bynes through the defense, down in the right corner. Savage dials a long jumper, short, barely drew iron, and the rebound, Okoye. Glasgow on the outlet up the right side. Looking down low, got it to Covington, turns and faces Smith, works the baseline, entry inside to Brown, throws it up and drew the foul. What a play. Personal against Guarino, his second. Timeout on the floor, 15-19 left second half. George Washington 42, VMI 40, but the Keydets have free throws coming up. From the Smith Center, happy holidays. This is GW Basketball on 1500 AM. Brian Albin, Colonial seemingly have not done a great job of shooting three-pointers all season, but especially here at Smith Center. 0-9 here in this game, and just really don't seem to have that much confidence from the outside, and that's hurting them right now against VMI and their 2-1-2 zone.
Well, VMI is stepping it up, being aggressive, trying to force some turnovers with the full court press, but if they don't force turnovers, just dropping into the zone, trying to make GW shoot over the zone as opposed to being able to dump it inside. But still, GW's found a way to get some points in the paint. Dwayne Smith's been very good catching it in the high post and being aggressive attacking the rim.
26-14 advantage for GW points in the paint. But now VMI is getting to the line here in the second half as Brown hits the first one, and he can tie the game here. Left-handed free throw good. Game tied at 42 with 15:19 on the clock. Marshall comes in for Brown, and facing the man-to-man full court, Smith gets the ball to Bynes. Bynes facing the trap. Guarino trying to get the ball across, gets it over to Bynes. Bynes comes across, puts on the brakes, back to Guarino, back to Bynes. 1-3-1 zone now continues. Try to trap with Okoye at the top, very similar to what GW does sometimes on defense. 9 on the shot clock now for Bynes on the left wing. He'll drive into the mouth of the defense, out to Guarino. Guarino can't find anything, gets it to Armwood. He's double teamed, forces the shot, it's going to be short on the right side, and the rebound for VMI. Philip Onglade gets the rebound. Rodney Glasgow between the circles. Through a screen, the stutter step, can't find anything, gets it outside. Stan Okoye, leading scorer, is having a nice second half, trying to go one-on-one against Guarino. Cuts him off, but Okoye continues on, fires, and can't get it to roll through. Over the back of Guarino. Chroma goes after it. They say it's off of GW.
And meanwhile, you know, it's VMI just throwing several different defensive looks at GW, causing some issues on the offensive end for the Colonials.
Marshall, the three is good out of the corner. 45-42, Keydeds. And now it is a 14-4 run for VMI. And a timeout for the Colonials. Full timeout for George Washington as they try to figure out this 14-4 run for the Keydeds after that three from Marshall. Timeout on the floor at the Smith Center. GW down by three. This is Colonials basketball on 1500 AM. NovaCare Rehabilitation, preferred provider of physical therapy to the GW Colonials and you. NovaCare, the power of physical therapy. Byron Kerr and Brian Albin courtside, 14:08 left, and Colonials needed a timeout. Keydets hit a three-pointer from the corner, their sixth of the game, and now they lead 45-42.
Well, a 16-7 start to the second half for VMI. Totally the opposite of what we were looking for here.
Bynes gets it to Armwood. Guarino almost walked in the backcourt. Back to Bynes. Comes across the timeline. And will set it up for the Colonials. Bynes works his way to the right side. Hand off Guarino. Bouncer is down low. Up and under. Move for Smith, and he's having the day. It's good. 45-44 VMI.
Hard to believe that VMI would go back to a man-to-man defense and allow easy bucket in the paint from DW.
Glasgow has it on the right side. Feeds it to Okoye against Smith this time. Okoye trying to break him down, does go down the lane, blocked by Smith, but a foul. Armwood or Dwayne Smith. It will be Dwayne Smith picking up his second. And Okoye really attacking the rim here in the second half.
Well, it's interesting that they called a blocking foul on Dwayne Smith. It was Dwayne Smith who got beat off the dribble and looked like he tried to block it from behind. So maybe he got him on the arm, but I'm not sure a blocking call could be there.
So Okoye, who's been setting up shot at the free throw line, misses that one back rim. Now 5 of 7 from the line in the second half. Kapriva is in. Smith is out. Bynes will get a breather. Mikic, we haven't seen in quite some time, is in for the Colonials. They try to get some outside shooting going. Okoye hits another free throw, 46-44 VMI. Patricio Guarino to Lasan Chroma, up the left side. Mikic doesn't drive, puts on the brakes, kicks it back out. Looked like he had an opening down the left side. And Guarino has it up to Lasan Chroma. Chroma has it to Mikic on the wing right. Up top to Chroma, left side Guarino, entry, good one to Kapriva, lays it up too hard, tapped by Armwood though, from the right side, rolls through. Game tied at 46, Armwood keeping it going for the Colonials, he's got 12. Glasgow has it up the right side, kicks it back for Onglade to Marshall. Glasgow, left open three-pointer, no good, in and out, tapping at Covington, out of bounds. To George Washington, they say.
Well, and I'm not sure about that one either. Looks like it might have been off Guarino, but could be a bit of a makeup call for a minute ago when it looked like Guarino had it. Somebody come straight over his back and they called it off him.
Chroma up the left side. Mikic again left open. Left wing, long jumper, back rim, no good. And Chroma somehow comes down and gets the rebound.
But that's at least what the coaching staff wants to see. Nemanja's in the game to be a shooter. When he gets looks, he's got to take them.
Lasan Chroma on the right side to Guarino. Mikic up top will drive. Goes back outside to Guarino. He's on the right side. A tough shot from the corner. It's good! First three-pointer of the game for the Colonials, and Patricio Guarino nails it, giving GW the lead back 49-46.
And a nice job by Mikic using his height to throw that one over the top of the zone. Nice skip pass.
Made three in the first 1-3-1 from the Colonials. Marshall will pump fake and drive. Fires left side off the glass rim. No good. Mikic has position over the back as Anglade. Foul. Anglade picks up his first. Timeout on the floor. A nice little turn of events for the Colonials. 11:52 left in the second half. Five straight for GW. They lead at 49-46 over VMI. This is Colonials basketball on 1500 AM. And trying to boost the confidence of their shooters. And the Colonials starting to take advantage as Patricio Guarino hits one. He's been one of the more consistent three-point shooters the Colonials have had this year.
Very solid all-around player, and nice to see him catch one in rhythm, fire it away, and knock it down.
Larson will bring it up left side because nobody's guarding him. Smart play, comes across the timeline. Gets it to Lasan Kroman. With 11:42 left in the game, GW has the ball up 49-46 over VMI. Kroman working his way right side, hand checks all over the place by Glasgow. Are you kidding me? Driving down the left side, he's bumped three times, no call. Guarino will drive right side, the jumper off the glass rim, no good. But somehow Kroma gets the rebound away from Gore, and he'll set it back up. Now he'll drive into the defense ball, knocked out of bounds by Glasgow. It'll stay with George Washington. Offensive rebounds big for Lasan Kroma today. He's got five overall boards. Lasan Kroma on the baseline, out to Guarino. Guarino is trapped, gets it to Mikic, spins to the top of the key over right side Kroma. Kroma fires from 17 short. Tapped by Capriva, tapped again by Guarino, and gets it back. Another chance. Out to Kroma. The zone still waiting for him from VMI.
Well, and Lasan being forced to play a little point guard right now with neither Brian or Joe in the game.
Guarino has it, top of the key. Entry down low, Larson spins, fires, right-handed hook shot around, no good. Capriva taps it in, and one over Okoye. Talking about the muscle, Capriva shows it again there, and the Colonials' lead is five.
Well, and the reason why that play's available, he's playing the baseline against the zone. He does a great job. Once that ball gets into the high post, once it looks like Larson's going to shoot, he makes sure he slides underneath that other defender on the baseline, puts a body on him and backs him up, gave him the inside position for that rebound.
They give the foul to Covington, his third. Capriva caroms off on the free throw attempt. So it's 51-46, George Washington, with 10:43 left. Rodney Glasgow arrives at the top of the key, goes in the corner, long three for Brown, short. Long rebound, Capriva had it for a moment, scales the ladder and grabs it himself again. Scoop pass up to Lasan Kroma. Over to Guarino, goes all the way through the baseline, blocked away by Covington. And Brown the rebound for VMI. Glasgow up the middle of the floor. It is Okoye over to Glasgow, the entry to Gore. Brown up top to Okoye. Back over to Glasgow, pump fakes, drives. Outside Gore, settles his feet. Back over to Glasgow, thinks about the three, drives. Outside to Gore, sets his feet, the long three, no good. Covington gets the rebound underneath, misses the jumper, and Larson the board. Out to Lasan Kroma. No look pass to Mikic, puts on the brakes. Backs it out to the corner. To Lasan, back to Mikic, three-pointer right side, short front rim. And Okoye got the rebound. They say the ball was out of bounds over the backboard, but it didn't look like he touched anything. VMI gets the ball at 9:41 left, second half.
And the shot was no good there, but that's the shot you want him to take. He had his feet set, caught it in rhythm, was ready to shoot. It would have made it a 12-1 run for GW had he knocked it down since the 14-15 mark, but nonetheless, GW still back in control with a five-point lead here.
VMI basketball. Glasgow threw a screen to the free throw line. Bynes almost got a piece of it from behind. Bad pass by VMI. Into the backcourt, it's a turnover. Brown couldn't get it back to Glasgow, and the defense making VMI make a mistake.
Well, it's a very nice job. You're in a 1-3-1. Shooter catches the ball in the corner. You have to rush a hard double team there. Make sure these guys can't get jump shots up. The double team forced Brown into a bad pass.
Only one turnover here in the second half for George Washington. And that's the first turnover of the second half for VMI. Brian Bynes has the basketball to McDonald, kicked away by Okoye, but it'll stay with GW. 9:16 on the clock, 51-46 Colonials. Looking to extend the lead here. Some breathing room against a very good three-point shooting team. 1-3-1 zone again for VMI. Armwood goes down low to Capriva, and he dunks it with two hands. Bullet pass from Armwood, 53-46 George Washington.
And that was all started by the nice look from Joe McDonald into the high post.
Corner three-pointer is good for VMI. like it was Tim Marshall again. Had some huge three-pointers in the second half with 8 points overall, 53-49 Colonials. Mikic, three-pointer from the left side. Yes! Finally for Mikic, he's got to say. Second of the game for the Colonials, 56-49 GW. Okoye top of the key, right side Marshall, itchy trigger finger. Ball knocked away, it's loose. But they're going to say it's out of bounds off of the Colonials.
Well, Marshall delivered a huge bucket. It was the first field goal for VMI in about 5.5 minutes, and then Mikic just says, no, I can answer that one. Puts it back up to 7.
Okoye has the basketball, will inbound, gets it to Covington. Covington back to Okoye, what a play. He lays it in. 56-51, George Washington.
Well, how often do you see the defense fall asleep on the inbounder? Okoye, a great job of throwing it in and sprinting to the hoop.
Armwood tried to block the shot, but Okoye had the angle. Bynes has it on the right side, up top to McDonald. Pump fakes on three. Bynes on the right side doesn't shoot it. Capriva free throw line. And a dangerous pass. Carr almost got the steal. Joe Carr knocks it out of the hands of McDonald, but it'll stay with GW. Timeout on the floor, 7:59 left, second half. George Washington 56, VMI 51. This is Colonials basketball on 1500 AM. Here it is, George Washington holding on to a 56-51 lead over VMI. Colonials get the ball, Mikic inbound to Joe McDonald. 7:57 left. McDonald, the right side handoff from Mikic, gets it back. 8 on the shot clock for Bynes to the free throw. Now to McDonald, long jumper from the right side. Good! Inside the line, Joe McDonald. 58-51, George Washington. Nice feed for Bynes. And the Colonials get up by 7 again.
One. Joe catching it in rhythm, looking to be a scorer, has a nice jump shot when he just is willing to take it and catches in rhythm, ready to shoot.
Joe Carr here in the second half drives against McDonald down to the baseline. Works the baseline underneath the basket, goes out to Okoye, the long jumper, no good. Rebound, Joe McDonald. Comes out of the scrum up the left side. Through the Smith screen on the right wing. Over to Mikic, long three-pointer, right side. In and out, no good. And the rebound, Okoye. Brian Brown on the wing right. Okoye to the free throw line. In the corner, a long three-pointer is good for Tim Marshall. 58-54, George Washington. He has 4 three-pointers in the game.
And that's the urge you have to be willing to fight off. You can't really help against, you know, to drive against this team and leave three-point shooters, which is what Mikic did there.
4 of 5 three-pointers from Marshall. Mikic lost a hand, got back to Smith. Smith will drive, float, and hit! And one coming up for Dwayne Smith. He's got 12 points, and the Colonial lead is back to 6.
Well, and Dwayne's found a home in the middle of that zone today when they've gone to the zone. catching it in the high post with space and time to then think about his move. He's been especially strong going to his left here in this second half.
14 points against Kansas State, 8 at Rutgers for Dwayne, and 12 already today against VMI in the last three games. Foul against Okoye. Free throw good, Smith.
And it's not surprising to see Dwayne pick it up at this time of the year. That's typically been his MO over the course of his time here. Tends to get things going after about 7-8 games.
Carr, the crossover dribble, bouncing off of McDonald, hands off to Okoye against Armwood, floats three, blocked by Armwood. Charge against Okoye as Dwayne Smith once again takes the charge, his second of the game. And it's Colonials basketball.
Just a very good job once again, seeing the offensive player with the dribble, putting his head down, not really looking where he's going. That's the perfect time to slide into a good help position.
Dwayne Smith gets the ball in from Armwood, over to McDonald, now to Chroma. Chroma needs to get the ball across, gets it to McDonald, bursts through the middle of the lane, goes all the way through, layup is no good. Smith fights for the rebound, gets it out to Lasan Chroma. Chroma the crossover, and he'll back it out.
And that's great to see from Dwayne. We talked about in the first half, too many times he was catching and just going right back up with it without looking where he was. Saw Chroma open, got it out to him, reset the offense.
Lasan has it on the left side against the zone. Up top, long jumper by Dwayne Smith, and what is going on here? Three-pointer for Mr. Smith, 64-54, largest lead of the game for the Colonials.
And that's shooting with confidence right there.
Marshall will weave his way through the floater, no good. Rebound, Armwood. Out of bounds off of Covington. It'll be GW ball. 2 years ago, Dwayne Smith hit 18 three-pointers. Last year, only two. This year, hit another three-pointer here. He has a couple this season and really feeling it, getting his shot going. And the Colonials watching a timeout with VMI up by 10, their largest lead, 64-54.
And what's nice to see about Dwayne Smith having the confidence to shoot that three is, where is he getting that confidence from? And he's gaining that confidence from taking the ball inside early, not trying to start his game outside. He's starting by attacking the rim, and then that brings some confidence. And once he gets that going, nobody's going to play him outside at the three-point line. He's got to take that shot, especially if he catches it in rhythm against his own. If they're not going to respect it, you got to make them respect it, and Dwayne did just that by knocking it down from the top of the key.
Colonials 0-for-9 to start from downtown. They've hit three of their last five from outside the arc.
And you don't need to be a team like VMI that shoots 29 and hits around 9, 10, 11 a game to be successful from the three-point line. You just need to hit enough so that the defense has to respect it.
Dwayne Smith, the inbound to Isaiah Armwood, up middle of the floor, Garino. Garino on a break, possible 3-on-2, holds it up, though, as he sees a trailer. And McDonald has it outside at 5:33 left in the game. Colonials leading by 10.
And that's smart. Last thing you need to do right now is force a shot early in the shot clock. That's what VMI is looking for.
Armwood low blocks against Covington, turns and faces, backs in with the left hand underneath, trying to scoop, but he traveled.
It's probably better that he got called for the travel there, as it looked like he dipped his head in his shoulder trying to create a little space. Did he not drag his pivot foot, it's possible he could have been called for an offensive foul a second later.
Only 9 turnovers in the game for GW. Lasko has it outside for VMI. Looking down low, the feed to Covington, backing in against Smith. Turnaround is a tough angle. Didn't quite have his body squared. And easy rebound for McDonald up the right side for Garino.
He took off in the air without even finding the rim.
Smith has it top of the key. He'll drive. Spins against Anglade, up and under off the glass, a little bit short. Rebound by Okoye, out of bounds off the Colonials' Garino, who dives into the second row, caught by his teammates on the bench.
And you can see Coach Lonergan talking to Dwayne Smith after that shot there, saying that's a little too early in the shot clock. We got a 10-point lead, 4:50 to go. Let's take a little time.
Dwayne Smith with 16 points, a season-high total. 3 rebounds and 2 charges taken. Outstanding work so far for Mr. Smith today. Lasko lost the dribble, got it back. 4:38 left on the right side. He'll drive against McDonald, spins, kicks it out for Covington against Larson, who tries to force the shot. Larson's there to block it and get the rebound. Hands off to McDonald up the left side. over to Patricio Guarino. Goes right in the middle of the lane. The floater is blocked away. And Marshall a two-on-one. Over to Glasgow, up the right side against McDonald. Layup no good! Marshall taps the rebound to himself. Backs it out to the left wing. Over to Koye against Guarino. Drives, ball knocked out of bounds. It'll stay with VMI. Great defense by McDonald on that two-on-one to even get into the play.
Well, he did a good job establishing position, making Glasgow try and avoid him, which kind of threw off his layup. But on the other end, you know, if you're Patricio, once again, slow it down. Pull it back out once you've broken the press. No need to try and attack 5-6 seconds into the shot clock and force something.
Covington has it out left wing. Off the screen, Okoye, low block, just 8 feet from the bucket. Turns around against Guarino, jumper swish. Nothing he can do about that. Good defense by Guarino, but Okoye makes the shot, 64-56. GW. Up the middle floor, Armwood will drive to the paint. Is blocked away by Covington, binds underneath the bucket. No man's land, gets it back out to McDonald to set it up. 46 rebounds today for GW.
And a smart senior play by Brian Bynes, not trying to go right back up with it.
McDonald down low. Armwood goes up for the stuff, but instead pushes it against the glass when he feels the shot block and lays it in. 66-56, Colonials. Joe Carr, the entry. Covington low blocks against Larson again. Forces the shot off. Not much contact there. It's Covington initiating. He draws the foul, though. I've liked Larson's defensive effort there the last couple against the active Covington. Foul, though, against GW there. Timeout on the floor, 3:21 left. Colonial 66, Keydets 56. This is GW Basketball on 1500 AM. Game-high 16 points, a season-high total for Dwayne Smith, 14 for Isaiah Armwood. Colonials out-shooting the VMI Keydets. Points in the paint 38-18 and bench points 33-16. Lead at 66-56 with 3:21 left.
And Dwayne Smith, obviously the key to that bench point statistic with 16 off the bench today, really spurring that effort for the Colonials.
Rebound advantage is 46-29 as Covington goes to the line. Free throw is good. For DJ Covington, he's got 5 points. Covington averages 14.4 a game. Second one for Covington, good. 66-58 GW. 3:21 on the clock for Armwood. Gets into Larson, and here comes Lasan Chroma trying to break the press up the right side. Sluttership on the wing against Marshall. Defense all over him. Feeds it over to Larson on the wing right. Gets it to Guarino. Guarino down the lane, lost the handle, steal. Taken away by Englade. Carr all the way through. Levels Joe McDonald. Offensive foul against Carr.
And what Joe does a great job of in transition in these one-on-one situations, he finds a spot above the circle where he thinks the offensive player might want to go and just gets set there. He doesn't really worry so much about trying to meet the offensive player. he just gets to a spot and makes the offensive player adjust. And sometimes that's hard to do when you already have a specific idea in mind.
Larson gets it to Chroma. Armwood tries a windmill reverse lay-in. Doesn't go, but he draws the foul. And Covington picks up number four. 2:49 left. Armwood will go to the line. Each team with 17 fouls. Each team with three timeouts left.
Well, Isaiah is very athletic, can make plays like that, but I'd like to see him just use the left hand and try and use the left side of the glass there.
14 points, 8 rebounds, 2 assists for Armwood. 2 of 3 at the stripe. First one up is good. Swishes it home. 67-58 Colonials. Guarino in for Larson. One more coming up for Armwood. Smith and Armwood, the only players in double figures for GW. Free throw is good by Armwood. He matches Smith 16 apiece, and the lead is back to 10, 68-58. Carr has the ball to Glasgow. Backing down low is Okoye, held by McDonald. McDonald's fourth.
And you don't want fouls right now, especially since you have 18 fouls. You're sending VMI to the line, only had to use 8 seconds on the possession. Chance for Okoye to get those 2 points right back in a very time-efficient manner.
Philip Anglade comes back in for Marshall at 2:41 left. Okoye not scoring the first half, but he has 10 here in the second half. 7 rebounds and 6 assists. Okoye free throw is good. 68-59 Colonials. Okoye with only 7 points against Wright State. That was the first time this season he was held under double figures. Free throws are good. He's in double figures in this game with 12, and it's 68-60 GW.
And even though he's gotten into double figures, Patricio's done a very nice job on him for most of the day.
Carr has the ball, trying to knock it away rather from Armwood, and Carr knocks it out of bounds. It'll stay with GW, but this time from the sideline right. Chroma will inbound with GW leading by 8. Shot clock did not even start. Armwood gets the ball into McDonald. McDonald races across the left side, sideline, into the front court for Brian Bynes. Bynes gets the call against Joe Carr. Backing way out, working the half court stripe. Bounce pass to McDonald, fouled by Brian Brown. His first, and free throws for McDonald's. And now the Colonials can show what they can do at the line. So we talked about a 70% team free throw shooting this season.
And if you're going to ice this game, you're going to have to do it from the free throw line. So we'll see what Joe can do here.
McDonald, 5 points, 5 rebounds, 4 assists today, 1 of 2 at the line. As Tim Marshall, their three-point marksman, comes back in, Philip Anglade. Baucom trading defense and offense. Colonials 15 of 18 at the line today. McDonald rattles home the first one. 69-60 GW. 2:25 on the clock. Colonials haven't played since December 11th. VMI hasn't played since December 8th. And this will only be the one of two games in a matter of 19 days for the Colonials when they play Sacred Heart on the 30th. So they don't like to get this one before the holiday Christmas break. Okoye down the left side. Up and under move is a nice one against Guarino. Floats in 70-62. GW timeout for VMI with 2:12 left on the clock.
Well, it looked like everybody was thinking don't foul, don't foul, and don't leave the three-point shooters. So it left Patricio in a bit of a difficult spot there trying to defend Okoye, who has a wider body, a little bigger than Patricio. It's a tough finish.
Finals in the A-10, UMass beat East Carolina 88-81. Butler over Evansville 75-67. Rhode Island downs Georgia State 65-60. LaSalle over Sacred Heart 171. Fairfield stuns St. Joe's 60-57. Florida State over Charlotte 79-76. Wofford shocks Xavier 56-55. NC State leading St. Bonaventure 85-68 with 2:39 left. Richmond leading George Mason 61-58. The Patriots on a big run. They cut it to 3. They were down double digits with 3:45 left. St. Louis leads Loyola Marymount 40-29 with 13:08 left. Biggest upset of the day, Temple surprises number three Syracuse, 83-79, Orange's first loss, and Dayton over Murray State, 77-68. Brian Bynes to the inbound against full court pressure. Guarino gets it over to Bynes. Bynes will race up against Carr, trying to come across the timeline. Got it to Chroma, lost the handle, got it back. No look into Larson, and he lays it in. A 72-62 lead for GW, 2 minutes left. Okoye drives against Guarino, knocks him down. Offensive foul out of control. Okoye lost the handle as he went through, picks up his fourth foul, and Guarino with the big D.
Oh, and Patricio's been there to meet him all day long. Finally gets an offensive foul. You felt like he'd get one before the day's over. Big time play from Patricio.
Mikic coming in for Bynes. Smith is back in with 1:55 left. Guarino in the backcourt against Anglade. Drives up the left side, picks up his dribble, scoop pass back behind him to Chroma. Ball knocked away and stolen by Brown. Carr has it at the free throw line, pump fakes, gets it over to Brown, back over to Carr. Carr will drive right side, not even looking for a shot, throws it cross court for Okoye. He'll fire a three and hit. 72-65 with Washington with 1:34 left, and a technical foul against VMI's coach. Boy, that is not good for the Keydets as they try to get the comeback going, and Duggar Bauckham has been all over the officials the entire game, and finally they've had enough.
Well, you finally got within seven with a minute 34. You can't do that. You can't do that to your players who have been working to get back into this game. You know, your players have been fighting, scrapping, forced a big turnover, hit a big three, and you just take them right back out of the game by picking up a technical and giving GW two free throws here.
And really, the coach is still going after the officials, and just not a smart move in so many ways. You've got your team waiting for you in the huddle. You're not talking to them. They're not going over any game strategy. And it's just not worth it right now. Time is of the essence. It's 1:34 left. You really need to be focusing on your team after they just hit a huge three-pointer. But instead, you've given up a technical foul the Colonials can take advantage of, and now you're still going after the officials.
He's risking getting run right now from this game and giving GW an additional two free throws, which wouldn't really help the VMI cause anymore.
Isaiah Armwood is going to shoot the free throw for the Colonials. First one is in the air, splashes home good. 73-65, and now he can really put salt in the wound with making this one and erasing two of the 3 points that Okoye just hit on the three-pointer, and he does. Free throw is good by Isaiah Armwood. Big shots for the Colonials. 74-65, and they have the basketball with 1:34 left.
I mean, as a coach, there are certain technicals you have to pick up. You know, when you're fighting for your team in the middle of the game and you feel like you're not getting the share of the calls, that's the type of technical you pick up. You don't pick one up with a minute 34 to go when your team's trying to fight and claw back into a game down by seven.
McDonald runs the baseline, gives it to Mikic on the baseline. Back inside is McDonald. He'll race up the sideline, gets it over to Smith. Smith puts on the brakes, back out to Mikic. Mikic will pump fake outside to Guarino, outside to McDonald. 1:22 left. Carr trying to grab at McDonald. No calls. Gets it over to left side to Mikic. Mikic throws the pump fake inside, goes outside to Armwood with 14 on the shot clock. Back to Guarino. Guarino looking down low, gets it to Dwayne Smith with 10 on the shot clock. Over to Mikic, 18-footer left side, no good. And the rebound, Covington. Covington up the middle of the floor with 57 seconds left. Okoye against Guarino, drives, fires, around, no good. But there's Okoye right there, can't get the layup to go on the rebound. Ball loose on the floor, Okoye's got it again and drew the foul. Relentless effort from Stan Okoye, and he'll be awarded with some shots at the line as McDonald is slow to get up. Well, and he is fouled out of the game.
Okoye not quitting on this one, but on the other end there, great possession from GW. Yes, it did not end up in points, but they beat the pressure, were in a hurry, had a couple chances where they almost took a quick shot, instead pulled it out, ended up using 28 seconds off the shot clock, and then took a smart shot. Even though Mikic didn't hit it, it was a good look from 17 feet. You can't ask for a much better possession than that when you have a 9-point lead and you're running the clock down to about a minute.
Bynes will come in for McDonald. McDonald fouls out, 7 points, 5 rebounds, and 4 assists. With 46.5 seconds left, Okoye gonna go to the line. He's 8 of 10 for the line here in the second half. Free throw, Okoye, in and out, no good. Big miss there for VMI. Okoye, 17 points, 9 rebounds, 6 assists. All of his points in the second half. Misses the second one on purpose. Gets his own rebound, fires from the right side and splashes it in. What a shot, what a play by Okoye. 74-67 GW. Right on his average with 19. Bynes has it up the right side of Garino. Over to Smith! And emphatically, he dunks it with two hands. 38 seconds left. 76-67 GW. Okoye bouncing off of Garino. Down the left side, forces the shot, no good side rim. His teammate Carr had a chance, and Armwood takes it away, throws it in the backcourt, but there's Brown to get it back. 22 seconds left, no reason to foul now. Okoye at the left side over to Carr. Carr will work the baseline, never shoots. Gives it out to Okoye, he'll fire a long shot, no good. Armwood taps the rebound to Bynes, and that will do it with 10 seconds left. The Colonials are gonna snap a three-game losing skid with a big second half. Thanks to Dwayne Smith and Isaiah Armwood combining for 18 points apiece, and the Colonials win it 76-67 over VMI, improving to 5-6 on the season. Mike Lonergan's coming up next after this timeout. You're listening to GW Basketball on 1500 AM.
Congratulations to your